Standing in the Harmony Garden here at the Cargill Church on Janesville's east side. As March draws to a breezy, cloudy close, the garden is in a dormant state. It gave up its growth for winter. Lent is drawing to a close as well, the Lenten season being a time that some people give something up, giving up sweets or caffeine or some other habit, a practice that dates to the early Christians observing a time of self-sacrifice and self-discipline. Lent is voluntary. A garden giving up new growth for winter is a logical consequence of living at the 42nd parallel and the resulting cold, snowy winters. What comes next? For us, it's Easter. The point of our self-sacrifice and reflection being to open us to new possibilities and new life. For this garden? Well, who knows? As a parable of life, it will sprout new life if tended and planted and cared for, or it will grow over with weeds if left to nature's whims and human neglect, or it can be turned over to a fallow state, allowed to rest, recover, and replenish its nutrients. This gives the land the chance to bounce back and be as fertile as ever when it's planted again. We're at that kind of crossroads now. More than a year of pandemic life has caused some of us to expend great energies in mastering new growth. Others have, by choice or circumstance, dialed down the always-on mode of daily living and adapted to a more subdued rhythm. Others have perhaps gone fallow, just waiting. Easter tells us that a new season is upon us. The church is big on seasons. Easter is intentionally preceded by a fallow period, a time of giving something up and redirecting that energy toward new purposes. And Easter ushers in new life. Easter, too, is not meant for only a day. What will the Easter season mean to you? What new possibilities lie ahead? What new productive energy will be redirected from toil that has been unproductive? Forget the former things, the prophet told us. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I hope your Easter is a time to perceive the new thing God is doing in your life, whether it is spurring new growth, planting new seeds, or lying fallow in order to re-energize. We'll see you next time.